Hey everyone, I'm Mike Kazimer. Once again, it's time to take a look at some fresh new bikes. Today, we have the Transition Spire and the Patrol. Both are new for 2021. While the overall look is in line with what you'd expect from Transition, the geometry numbers take them into a whole new realm of low and slack. In addition, they're available with aluminum frames, something Transition fans have been asking for quite some time now. There's also a carbon spire though, just in case you had a hankering for some fantastic plastic in your life. Let's start by going over the Patrol. Now that name has been in Transition's lineup before, but like I said, this is an entirely new bike for 2021, and it's got a mullet this year. So 27.5 inch rear wheel, 29 inch front, and 160 millimeters of travel. If you wanted to have a little bit more squish, you can put a longer stroke shock on it and get 170 millimeters of rear travel. Now, I mentioned that these bikes are pretty slack. I wasn't kidding. The Patrol in the high setting has a 63.5 degree head tube angle. That's pretty much the same number that you'd find on a downhill bike. If you want to go even slacker, you can knock that back by half degree with a little flip chip at the bottom of the shock mount. I'll drop that down to 63 degrees. So very slack. Also has super low bottom bracket height. And that's accompanied with some 165 millimeter cranks just to help you avoid any unwanted rock strikes. Other geometry numbers to note, you've got a steep 78.1 degree seat tube angle, a reach of 485 millimeters, and chainstay length that varies depending on the frame size. So small and medium sized frames have one length, and then the large and XL, those have another length. In this case, it's a large behind me that has 440 millimeter chainstays. Now, time to move on to the new big dog in Transition's lineup, the Spire. This beast right here. This one, 29 inch wheels, front and rear, 170 millimeters of travel, and it's even slacker. That's right. Head angle on this is 63 degrees in the high setting, drops all the way down to 62.5 degrees in low setting. So again, super slack geometry that puts it in the realm of a downhill bike, but one that you can pedal. Because once again, this bike has that steep 78.1 degrees seat tube angle. It also has a reach of 485 millimeters for the size large. There's a wider range of sizes available for the Spire, so you can go from extra small all the way up to XXL. Should accommodate a wide range of rider heights, and Transition has the chainstay length that depends on the size. The smaller sizes get 446 millimeter chainstays, and then the XL and XXL, those have 452 millimeter chainstays. There's also a carbon version, like I said, of the Spire, so if you want to shed a little bit of weight, which might not be a bad thing to consider. These bikes aren't exactly light. You're looking at around 36 pounds as they sit right here. So, you know, more aimed at the descents and not exactly going to fly up the hill, but we'll get to ride impressions in a second. That's enough talking about numbers for now. Let's dive into some frame details. And let's start at the front of the bike, the head tube. These bikes have a 1.5 inch straight head tube, something these days that's, again, typically only seen on downhill bikes. What does that let you do? Well, for one thing, super easy to run a dual crown fork. And yes, these frames are dual crown compatible, so you can rig up some kind of wild park bike if you like, get that Enduro dual crown going, or having that 1.5 inch straight head tube also leaves room for either an angle adjust headset or a reach adjust headset. Let's really fine tune the bike to make those numbers exactly suit your personal preference and riding style. On these bikes, the dropper and the derailleur housing are internally routed with foam sleeves to help keep things quiet, and the brake runs on the outside just to make things easier when it comes time for service. Another thing to note is SRAM's universal derailleur hanger. That's starting to catch on. It's good to see. It just means that you'll be more likely to be able to find a replacement easily in the event of a crash where it needs to be replaced. Now, how much will these cost? Well, frame and shock only will set you back $2,299, with complete starting at $3,699 and going all the way up to $5,499. Now, if you decide to go that carbon route, frame only and shock will go for $3,299 and complete start at $5,899. And before we go too much further, I need to mention something. Depends on the size of the screen that you're watching on, but if you look close, you'll probably see that this says that's a Patrol. It says that this is a Spire. That's not the case. This is the Patrol, and that's the Spire. I know, kind of confusing. What happened is Transition got some frames in, sent them off to the powder coater to get them all ready, so myself and some others could get some early test laps on them. And when they got them back from the powder coater, they were the wrong colors. Well, the right colors, but on the wrong frame. So they got switched around. So in any case, when these actually do come out, the Patrol, it's gonna be blue, and the Spire, it's gonna be orange. With the Patrol, it's the cornering that really stood out for me. I mentioned that low bottom bracket. This holds true for both bikes. It's really low, like lower than the geometry charts say low, and maybe a little too low. Not quite sure, but I think it'd be difficult to run these bikes in the low setting without worrying about smacking your cranks all the time. But it just kind of depends on where you're at. Either way, the low bottom bracket does improve a bike's cornering ability, and when you combine that with a smaller rear wheel on the patrol, it just absolutely rails. You can push in that suspension, load it up, and just know that it's gonna hold on through that corner. Climbing, it's actually not as bad as I thought. Now, there's no getting around. These bikes are on the heavier side of things, and they are really slack, so you have a little bit heavier steering, but it's not floppy, and a lot of that has to do with the steeper seat angle. It puts your weight over the front, so you're not getting that unweightedness. It doesn't want to just tip back and forth. It's pretty easy to control. Now, I'm not trying to say these are trail bikes or bikes that you want to go on, you know, super long cross-country oriented missions, but they are very pedalable, and the actual position is pretty comfortable. Both bikes are great at jumping, but with the patrol, just kind of felt like it had more of a goof-off ability to it. You know, let me manual, wheelie, hop and pop, and play around a little bit more than the Spire. So that's kind of more your goof-off bike. Spire is more of your serious bike, but neither of these are that serious. They're all made for good times. Moving on to the Spire, like I said, the Spire does have a little more serious feel to it. 29-inch wheels, front and rear. I could see it being a good race bike for the privateer racer, assuming the tracks are rowdy enough. And that slack head angle, it lets you get away with some crazy stuff in the steeps. Like, there was more than one time where I was on it and just found myself amazed at how much safer I felt. You know, it doesn't feel like you'll, there's no way you're gonna go over the front of the bike, and you can take corners with just tons of confidence. And again, even when you're climbing, it's not too bad. You know, I did some kind of more techie, chunkier stuff, and it doesn't feel like the bike is wandering or too slow. But again, you know, it is a slack bike, it is a longer bike, so not your ideal cross-country machine, but those numbers all coalesce into something that is more manageable than you would expect just looking at what they say on paper. The downsides to these two bikes, well, I mentioned the low bottom bracket on both of them. It's not gonna be for everyone. You also have those short cranks that accompany that, so that's something that could be a little bit polarizing. I think in the right scenario, it's not gonna be a big deal at all, and the performance benefits are gonna outweigh any cons, but something to keep in mind. You also have that weight to contend with. You know, they are aluminum frames, so a little bit on the heavier side. Like I said, around 36 pounds, depending on the build kit. You could probably get them a little bit lighter by going with lighter casing tires, that sort of thing. But overall, the general feel of these, it's got a cool, I'd almost call it more of a little bit unrefined, kind of raw feel to it. Almost like you're riding a prototype that somehow got snuck out of the test lab, but in a good way. They just kind of make you want to experiment. They made me want to go see what would happen when I rode super, super steep trails. And in every case, I came away really impressed. So Transition's doing something interesting here, pushing the boundaries a little bit further than most companies are doing. You know, there are a couple other companies that have entered this super slack realm, but it's kind of cool to see where they're going with it. And you know, I had a blast riding these bikes, and we'll report back once we get one in for longer term testing and see how it fares. That's it for the Transition Spire and the Patrol. Thanks for watching. As always, let us know what you think in the comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for plenty more Pinkbike tech content in the near future.